Today we're going to talk about kidney stone and its treatment. Kidney stone is a very painful condition, a troublesome condition. Patient has severe pain in the abdomen. Many a times this becomes an emergency, for which again Ayurveda has the best results. Why and how Ayurveda is needed for such condition of kidney stone, even though the condition is acute or there is a reoccurrence of kidney stone again and again. In cases of chronic kidney disease, CKD, if the patient is on dialysis, the kidney is damaged, to maintain the normal functioning, to overall have a proper maintenance of the kidneys, why and how Ayurveda is recommended, Ayurveda is needed, the Ayurvedic principles, why they are so important, we're going to discuss in this particular video. Tips, home remedies, treatment, causes, symptoms, procedures, medications, everything about kidney stone wherein you get the best result from day one. So watch till the end. If you have any doubts or questions, let us know in the comment section below. Let us begin with this video. Namaste everyone. Welcome back to Jovi's. More than 95% of the kidney stones, they can be bursted and expelled out successfully without surgery, just by applying the right Ayurvedic principles for the right patient. This condition, you know, kidney stone, it is illustrated, it is well known from the times of Dhanvantri. It is explained as Mutra Ashmari. Mutra is the urine, Ashmari is the stone. And since that time, it is well explained. What about the surgery? We all know about it now. But since 5,000 years, Acharya Shushrut, who is world's first surgeon, explains a complete, you know, complete explanation about the surgery of kidney stone in Shushrut Samhita, Chikitsasthan, 7th chapter. And upon the ideology of Acharya Shushrut, even Acharya Vagbhat in Ashtang Hriday explains the surgical procedure for kidney stone in Chikitsasthan, 11th chapter. Ayurveda has complete solution for this problem and various other problems of the kidneys, about which we are going to talk about some of them. So let us first understand the, you know, types of kidney stone. There are five basic kinds of stones. They are calcium phosphate, calcium oxalate, uric acid stones, ammonium stones, amino acid stones. As per the location, there are five types. As per the chemical composition, there are four types. Talking about the causes, why do kidney stones occur? What is the reason behind this? At least in today's time, the reason is repeated intake of the medications, the drugs, the rabeprazole, pantoprazole, domperidone, repeated intake of all these antacids or all these drugs. It creates a lot of toxicity in the body. And all these toxicity, how it's affecting, we'll discuss in the further part of the video. The other reasons are vitamin A deficiency, there is low water consumption, there is obesity, there could be chronic kidney disease due to which there is reoccurrence of kidney stones again and again. We need to overall have a 360 degree viewpoint about maintaining the healthy function of the kidneys. So over here, these are the causes. What happens exactly is the toxicity, it's retained in the body, and this toxicity, they sediment, they precipitate in the organ which is related to expulsion of the kleda, which is the one organ, which is bladder. And because of all these reasons, what happens is the urine gets concentrated, its acidity increases, it leads to dryness in the body, and it further leads to formation of the stone, which further leads to pain in the abdomen or burning, obstruction during urination. So all of this are the reasons and how it affects a patient. Again, talking about the treatment in Ayurveda, Ayurveda has proper classification, Vataj Ashmari, Pittaj, Kafaj, Shukraj or Tridoshaj. As per proper classification, there are various symptoms that are explained. An authentic Ayurvedic doctor listens to the patient properly, understands what is the classifications, which are the doshas that are involved, what is the prakriti of the person, and the right treatment is done for the right patient. So very, very important. You know, it in simple language, if I have to explain you, let's consider three stages of kidney stone in simple language. The first stage is where the patient has severe pain in the abdomen. Ayurveda says in such condition, apply Vathahar Chikitsa and you will get successful result. Vathahar Chikitsa, again, it's best for severe pains. In the second condition, the second stage, if we see patient, you know, complaints of burning in the body, burning in the stomach, in such condition, Pittahar Chikitsa is given. In the third stage, the last stage, patient has obstruction during urination, and this condition, patient, you know, they are advised to follow Kafahar treatment. Doctor gives Kafahar Chikitsa. So as per the person, as per the doshas involved, symptoms, proper classification, patient is put into classification and the right treatment is given for the right person. Today, Ayurveda has a lot of, you know, a wide range of herbs to treat this condition. What are the requirements of the herbs in kidney stone? Let us understand. Number one property, they should be sneha. They should be mild oleation, mild oleating action should be there. Second, they should be mutral, they should be diuretic, they should be analgesic, they should be vatahar, the ones that reduces the pain, reduces the vat, reduces the air element, the vayu in the body. And the next is they should be ashmari vedan, they should have the ability to break down the stones. And having all these gunas, Ayurveda has a wide range of herbs. Punarnava Gokshur, you're very much aware of this. These are famous Ayurvedic herbs. But beyond that, Ayurveda has a wide range of herbs. Some of them are Shigru, Varuna, Sukshma Ela, there is Shilajit, Karpas, Tinduk, there is Kutaj, a wide range of herbs. Shilajit is again one of them. Wide range of Ayurvedic medicine that are very much having the uttermost properties of the qualities that we just discussed. Talking about the formulation, there are endless formulations for dealing with such condition. In acute condition, emergency condition, Ayurveda has the Panchakarma. Panchakarma also helps in stopping or preventing or avoiding the reoccurrence of kidney stone. We've experienced in over hundreds of patients where the Virechan Karma or the Basti Karma has stopped the reoccurrence of kidney stone. Also, even though a patient chooses to go for a surgical procedure, even after surgery, there are certain Ayurvedic principles, Ayurvedic herbs that are needed in order to stop the reoccurrence as well as to, you know, give proper nourishment to have a proper functioning, a healthy function of the kidneys. Maintenance is always required in every aspect, and Ayurveda is the best when it comes to curative, preventive as well as promotive aspect. So Virechan Karma, Basti Karma, they are very, very useful. At least Virechan Karma once in a year, Basti once in a year. Virechan is the one that removes the aggravated pitta out from the body. Basti is that which removes the aggravated vat out of the body. Maximum problems are solved once the Panchakarma is done each and every single year for the overall well-being, for the maintenance of a person. Talking about the Ayurvedic remedies, again, Gokshur is a simple Ayurvedic herb that helps many patients from day one. Today, in every single highway, in the city, in the highways, in the villages, in the urban areas, we've seen that Gokshur is available. All by the, you know, in the roads, by the in the highways, everywhere today Gokshur is available. I'll put a picture over here so you can identify Gokshur very easily. The medicine, the supplement is available worldwide across the globe. We have an entire video on Gokshur, a complete video along with its shloka, its classical uses, complete video on Gokshur, and I'll put the link to that video in the description box below. So Gokshur is very, very useful, taking the leaves, making kada or with the churna. Again, Gokshuradi Google is an Ayurvedic medicine which has great results. What does it have? It has Gokshur, which is the Tribulus terrestris. It has Trikatu, which is Pipli Marichunti. It has Trifala, which is Amlaki, Haritaki, Vividaki. And it has Shuddha Google. It has Musta. What is Google? Google is Yogavai. It enhances the properties of other herbs that are mixed with it. So Gokshuradi Google, with Google, it enhances the qualities of the Gokshur. So such Ayurvedic medicine, Gokshuradi Google is a common medicine, it's a simple formulation. Ayurveda has a wide range of medicine when it comes to kidney related disorders. So this was all for today. Again, consumption of wheatgrass juice, 1 cup early in the morning, is again very, very useful for kidney related disorders. Consumption of, again, what is the diet aspect, what are the do's, what are the don'ts, we'll make another video on this. But just for you, since you've seen this video till here, do check out the description box. I'll make a chart for you specially. I'll put in certain foods to consume, foods to avoid, along with which we'll put in a proper chart, a link. You can just click on that link and view that chart, and you'll understand what are the foods you need to take, what are the foods you need to avoid. That will help you all from day one. So this was all for today. Ayurveda has beautiful results when it comes to kidney stone, reoccurrence of such kidney stones, as well as to maintain the healthy function of the kidneys. If you have any doubts or questions, let us know in the comment section below. Do like and share this video further. Until next time, from Jovis and the team, look impressive, be progressive.